as Mahani said, I am a corporate and commercial lawyer and an alternative dispute resolution practitioner in Uganda. Our innovation is called the Electronic Justice Solution, which was formerly the Electronic Dispute Resolution Network. We have created a platform that will connect providers of alternative dispute resolution, for example, mediation, arbitration, conciliation, negotiation. It will connect them to disputants or people who need these services. So our innovation is really a tech-based innovation. We are aiming to use the web, the mobile phone, and just your normal phone that is not tech savvy. I was motivated to come up with this innovation because of challenges that I was facing as court-accredited mediator and generally a practitioner of alternative dispute resolution. During the COVID-19 pandemic, the courts of Uganda were highly affected, and because of the standards of operation that were given by the government, the courts were shut down. And what I do entails me being a front provider or a front runner of all commercial disputes, where I mediate between parties in a more simpler, effective, and more relation-based kind of dispute resolution service to ensure that the parties try and solve their matters as fast as possible, so they don't have to go before a judge or start the traditional court process. But the COVID-19 pandemic, because we did not have access to court, most of the cases that we had scheduled or I had personally scheduled to mediate could not be done. So we realized that even as people who are providing alternative dispute resolution services, I did not have access to court, yet it's meant to be a more effective and user-friendly way of giving individuals or entities access to justice. So what motivated me was this real challenge that I had. So I had to think and find ways in which I could be able to provide the justice that, you know, the different individuals and entities that I was meant to provide these services to. So that is where the electronic or online dispute resolution idea was birthed. And the idea was then to think and say, can we have access to justice out of the ordinary traditional courts face-to-face system and have the same services offered online? But also, most importantly, is that the real challenges that are faced with the traditional courts, for example, confidentiality, data protection, trust, the user friendliness, are some of the things that we thought we had an opportunity to address and provide a seamless flow and accessibility. So this platform that we have created has features that we have worked on, have thought through, are in the process of testing and getting feedback from different users to ensure that the value proposition that we give to the general accessibility to justice are very real. So for example, some of the users or our targeted users are the already existing alternative dispute resolution providers. And this includes courts, it includes institutions that have been accredited by the judiciary to provide ADR services to support them to ensure that there is access to justice. So the features that we are creating on this platform, on our portal, are features like a virtual file where the disputant or the user of our platform can create a virtual file meaning that it will be very, very easy to create. You can create it yourself. You can create it through an entity that has licensed usership of our product. And there is control, which is not the same with a traditional court system. The information that is there is encrypted, it is protected, there is audit and accountability for whoever has access to that file. So information is protected. And this is something that we don't have in the traditional court system. For example, someone files a case, whether it's a family matter, which is very, very sensitive, or it's a commercial matter, you're looking at companies which need to protect their brands. And the moment this matter, this dispute enters the court files, they are splashed in the media. And a lot is affected with that. So this is one of the things we are trying to solve. How can we ensure that people trust accessing justice, people trust, especially people who have economic justice needs, that information is protected. So the role that mediation and other alternative dispute resolution mechanisms play in strengthening our justice system, it's very, very important. First of all, we are looking at mechanisms that can be very, very user-friendly, that can be very cost-effective, and that can save time. Mediation principally is a mechanism that is meant to help disputants from whichever category you are, from the lowest level of a dispute in terms of value to the highest level. Principally, it's meant to be a very, very confidential dispute resolution process. It is also meant to be a process that is very, very effective, very fast, and most importantly, that relationships are retained. People continue to operate despite of that dispute, which is something that is not in the traditional court system. You have a win-lose situation. At the end of the day, the matter is judged. One person loses, one person wins. And also, we find that because of the backlog and the lack of resources and enough capacity for the judiciary to service all the justice needs that are out there, we find that when we embrace mediation and other alternative dispute resolution mechanism, we find that everyone, every Ugandan, can be able to have access to justice for whatever need that they have. And also, in terms of trust, you find that the system, the traditional system, has been interpreted to be for a certain category of people. Yet everyone, every day, you experience an injustice. You experience some need that you need someone to either interpret the law for you or to just understand what are your rights. And because the traditional system is very formal, it is very calculative and has to be dealt with in a certain way, most Ugandans, and I mean most Ugandans, end up experiencing injustice and cannot have access to justice. So the role that ADR plays, and especially if we take it online and it's accessible to everyone, if you have a phone, if you have a computer, and the statistics show that the numbers of Ugandans are growing, even just a simple USSD enabled phone, you find that everyone will be able to have a chance at least to have their justice need addressed in one way or another. So I think that the ADR is not there to compete with the formal justice system, but it is a good mechanism to support and ensure that the objective that the judiciary and the justice services were created are fully met. I believe that innovation is very important. Creativity in how justice can be achieved is very important. So as a mediator, as an alternative dispute resolution practitioner, I think that this is the way to go. This is us moving our country forward, moving our economy forward, moving justice forward. So anything that can provide options and provide better ways that the main objective of justice is achieved is something that we should all fully embrace and support.